Hi everyone, this is Amanda and
Alexander.
And we're going to attempt to get the Halloween decorations out of the side attic. To make it even more dungeon-like, it has to be hard to open the door, so. Oh. Ooh. Does not look good in here, bubs. Click. Oh. St. Patty's Day, bum bum bum. Of course, it has to be 1,000 degrees. Are you kidding me? Oh, here we go. This is promising. Here's the box. Halloween. I bet you don't have a pumpkin Dremel. Please don't be jealous. That's one box. Doesn't really count though, because there's still baby stuff in it.
Whoa!
Switch to headlamp. Because it's. Oh, scary in here. I'm not entirely sure how a 200 plus person can be supported on these very small rafters, but I'm gonna go ahead and trust that. Someone built it accordingly. Well, we have books. I feel like you're not really putting much effort into it.
I can't do that.
Alright, Halloween decorations.
I was working in the lab late one night.
Nice.
When my eyes beheld an eerie sight, for my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
This part is kind of annoying because it requires me getting an extension cord. Putting it from the house all the way up to here, lighting this up, and then trying to untangle it and then place it best on this large bush. Good times.
He did the mash.
He did the monster mash. From my laboratory in the castle east to the master bedroom where the vampires feed.
Might have to give up on the purple strand for now, at least until Ed gets home, because he knows more about fixing these stupid Christmas lights than I do. I did the age-old trick of turn every bulb and see if it turns on, but half the strand still isn't lighting up, and then I went through, replaced the broken ones, and it still isn't working, so. There's little fuses, but I have no idea where those go, so I guess we'll wait. A graveyard, an idea originally inspired from my dad's. He made awesome graveyards when I was little, and I thought, man, I'd like to do that, so. I came up with my own idea of what to do with the graveyard.
The ghouls all came from their humble abodes to get a jolt from my electrode.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a great.
Every year I sacrifice a t-shirt to the large spider that we make for the web, and this year will be no different. Except it's sad because this is the first Dave Matthews Band shirt that Heather got me. The only problem is it's ripped in the pit and I've sewn it so many times and it won't stay, so unfortunately this will be the one that goes. It's got the logo and everything on the back of the Dreaming Tree. So if anyone is looking for something to get me for Christmas, a new Dave Matthews Dreaming Tree shirt would be awesome. But I am sad about this. Thank you, Heather, and I'm sure that you appreciate that the shirt is going to a giant spider. Alright, day two of try to turn your house into something spooky. Ed realized that he can't salvage the purple lights, so we're gonna have to trash them, which is a bummer. And it started raining today. It's kind of gray out. So I had to take the gravestones down, so those are down. But we did finish the spider, which I can go ahead and put up there. So, here it is. Ugh. I mean, it's pretty good, right? It's okay. It obviously doesn't look like a real spider, but... pretty awesome!
Hello, I'm Alex Sick, and I need to all everything about animals, princesses, and I believe hearts, and I believe pumpkins and skeletons, and I don't cry, and I don't believe.